Hey guys, it's your girl Melissa, and I'm back with another Halloween DIY video for you. So I'm going to show you how to make a living photo strip and the human Rubik's Cube. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. For the photo strip, we're going to need cardboard, black construction paper, scissors, glue, and some funky pictures of yourself. So we want our strip to be about our height, so I cut my box in half vertically twice, sorry I didn't get it on tape, and then I glued those two strips together. Now we're just going to arrange our pictures in whatever order you prefer. I wanted the second slot to be my cutout, so I measured that section out. So now we're going to cut black strips for our border. I just kind of lucked out with this groove on the inside of my box. I just aligned my construction paper on the groove and just cut down the line. Okay, so once all of our strips are cut out, I'm going to start off with the first picture. It's best to do picture by picture instead of gluing them down all at once. I'm using Mod Podge, by the way. I ran out of glue sticks, just in case you were wondering. So once I have my first picture glued down, I am then going to start gluing the black strips down, just literally just making a frame around the photo. And here are the final results. Lastly, with a box cutter, we're just going to cut out our window. Once you've hit all four sides, just pop it out and we're done. For the Rubik's Cube, you'll need three boxes, colored construction paper, black duct tape, some type of glue, scissors, and a box cutter. So I was unable to find the type of box that I wanted, so I made my own out of a Home Depot box that I got for like $1.42. And you just lay it down flat, unassembled, and cut out a square. I'll leave all the specs below. So you still have the top and the bottom, as you can see. This next part is probably the most tedious, but once you finish the first one, the second two are a piece of cake. So this is the hole that you want to fit through, but you don't want to slip off of your hips. So what I would suggest doing is drawing the shape of an egg, because the egg has a longer section and then a shorter section. So start off small and work your way up. Like, you probably are gonna have to try it on a few times to make your hole a little bit larger, but it's better to start smaller than bigger. So really quickly, I'm gonna show you guys how I made my box. So I cut strips and I aligned the strip parallel to the top of the box, and I taped it down and then I taped it under. So parallel, tape down, and tape under. And then you pop it up and you pretty much have the makings of your box. So parallel, tape down, and tape under. Box. And here are my three completed boxes. Each box is gonna have 10 squares on top and 14 rectangles around the outside. And so I found it easier to pre-cut those, and then you're just gonna arrange them on your box however you prefer. I found using a little piece of duct tape for spacing helped a great deal. So then we're just gonna put a little bit of glue on the back of each card, not necessarily to glue it down, but just to hold them in place. Oh yeah, make sure that you cut off the excess paper around the hole and you're ready to tape. My goal was always to make sure I could hit as many blocks as possible with one strip of tape. So I'm going for the yellow, the pink and green, and then the purple and blue on the side, and I'm just going to wrap it around the bottom. Clearly, taping is self-explanatory, but I'm just going to show you a few techniques that I did, and make sure you hit the top corner and then you're going to flip it over and get the bottom as well. And whenever I hit a corner, I always would slice the two pieces in half and wrap one piece around and the other piece down. So in half, around, and down. So you have pretty corners. So now we're gonna hit the corner of our box with a piece of tape. I definitely took full advantage of having one done, and I just made sure I lined up my lines with my first one. It just made the other ones easier. Challenge people to solve you, even though it's going to be impossible. But I love making these kind of videos for you. I hope you guys enjoyed them as well. Let me know what you're gonna be for Halloween. I love you, bye. like you said, it's hurting my arms.
Oh, you'll get over it. Hold it up.
Huh?
You'll get over it. Hold it up. Make some more.
Really?
Make some more faces.
Chris Jenner.
Hold it up and make faces. Go.